Halo Sobat Ikrar, saya sekarang sudah bersama dengan Dr. Valentin Gandhi. Beliau seorang data scientist dan research evaluation di bidang development sector. Bidang yang sangat-sangat unik menurut saya, karena jarang orang yang bisa dan memahami data di bidang development ini. Mari kita langsung perkenalkan saja. Hai, Dr. Valentin.
How are you?
Good, and you?
Hi,
my name is Valentine, and I work for the last 20 years in the development sector in nearly 60 countries, mostly as a researcher and evaluation expert. But because of my background in IT, I work a lot of projects which use information and communication technologies for use by the development sector. But I work primarily from a problem-solving perspective. I don't push for a technology, but really try to understand what problems can be solved by a particular technology.
What is your dream for development sector? It can be Indonesia or globally.
I mean, I think development sector is largely a misunderstood concept because many people don't grow up saying that I want to be in the development sector. Especially, I mean, you're from Indonesia, I'm from India. In our cultures, if you say you are a doctor or engineer, then you have achieved something in life. But if you say I want to be a development researcher, people wonder what's happening.
Who is development? I mean, is it software development?
Yeah. I often get those questions. So yeah, but actually it's a very fulfilling job, but it's not a very easy task because the development sector is on long-term solutions rather than quick fix to problems. So you don't often feel good. Like recently I was speaking at a TED conference where I talked about these feel good approaches. A lot of us want quick fixes, something that we can post in our Facebook and Instagram. But solutions to real world problems take a long time. You have to study them patiently. And you don't always get the goosebumps and butterflies in your stomach because it requires thorough study. Because we work in a very dynamic environment. Because we may have a nice technology, but it may not be suited in the area. So this requires careful study and careful research. So my dream for the development sector is it's more understood and it's more popular. Especially technology often tends to push the development sector. But with the advent of technologies like blockchain and AI, there is a chance for development sector to push the technologies based on the use cases rather than being pushed by IT companies or technology companies, so to speak. So that there's a balance between it. It's also beneficial for the IT companies because then if you're solving problems rather than just selling a bunch of phones, then your solution sells faster as well. Especially with regards to data, since you're from a data background, data is not unique to Indonesia, but it's globally data can be non-existent or fragmented and there are multiple versions of data. So I think we are at a good opportunity now to streamline the use of interventions based on evidence and based on uniform data.
Do you think is there any progress in the development sector based on what you have? I mean, the evidence base. Do you think now we have progress in
data? I think so. I mean, around in 2002, when I started as a researcher, data was a subsection of people who used data. Like only researchers or some big companies with data scientists. But now it's more and more getting popular. All of us have become data points since the internet revolution, and now with AI and blockchain. So there has been a tremendous progress and awareness, especially because information is available so much widely. So at least the modern generation or the young researchers and young development professionals that I work with are very very knowledgeable with regards to
in Indonesia and
globally as well.
And based on your experience in various countries, what is the most interesting story that you have been experienced when implementing the technology or innovation in different sectors?
Yeah, there's always great stories. Do you know, we live in a world where we say everything you can Google it.
Yeah.
You want information, Google it. But you can't Google wisdom. Wisdom comes from experience. Long time ago, I was doing a research with an organization which works on agriculture. And they were working on pigeon peas, which is a crop. And they have a pigeon pea variety. You know, it's a kind of a lentil.
Oh, I see.
Pigeon pea. Yeah. If you eat food, you
like the lentil.
Like chickpea, pigeon pea, and all. So the lentil is used, and they were introducing a new variety which is supposed to give higher yields. But when they were testing in the laboratory, it was very successful. But when they tested it in the field, it wasn't providing the results. Why? Because when we went and did the research, the cows used in the lab are much healthier and bigger cows than the one that is used by a poor farmer. So that's what I mean by wisdom. You know, wisdom requires careful study, experience, knowledge, research.
You have sense.
Yeah. So I mean, there are so many interesting studies, interesting stories. If you ask me, I will spend the whole day. But that's one thing that comes to mind.
Thank you for. If you have query, question to Dr. Valden, we will answer it. Dan kita akan ada Q&A, ya. Bisa kirim pertanyaan di sini. Nanti kalian coba send the answer of Dr. Valden regarding terkait tentang pemanfaatan data and innovation di development sector. Okay, we will close it. See you. Thank you.